In this video, let's talk about how to install Hive, the latest version 3.1.1 on Ubuntu. So these steps can work on Ubuntu 18.4, 16.04, and 14. So before we move on to the hands-on, let's quickly check on the requirements. The first thing is to have Hadoop pre-installed and make sure it is running. So even if it doesn't run, so we'll start it before we try to log into Hive. Second thing is to download the Hive version from the Apache Hive website, and the other steps I have clearly given. Now let's get into the hands-on. Okay, so as you can see here, I've already downloaded and kept it. Let's go back and extract this with Hadoop user. So again, if you don't have Hadoop installed, please check out my other video, which is currently shown here, on how to install and enable Hadoop. So let's extract this. Okay, so after extraction, the next step is to create a symlink. Okay, so as you can see, we have the symlink here. Okay, which is pointing to this extractor location. So if you can also move this hard link or the extractor location to /usr/local or to /opt, and from there also you can do a symlink. Next step is to go back and add the Hive specific variables into the bash rc. So I'm going to open my bash rc for the Hadoop user. So go back way below and let's put this five different variables. First is export Hive home. Hive conf directory. I missed the slash here. And export the path. Hive home bin. Next, export the class path. Hadoop home lib star colon dot. Okay, and also export the class path for Hive. Hive home lib. Okay, so these are the five variables that we need to set up. So let's quickly check if everything is fine. Okay, so once the changes are done, just execute the bash rc. So let's move to the hiveconf directory to change the okay. So Let's copy hive-env.sh.template to hive-env.sh. And let's open the hive-env.sh. Okay, so in this, the first configuration is to modify the Hive Hadoop home. So let's export the Hadoop home. Now let's copy the Hive default.xml template to Hive site.xml. So once these configuration changes are done, the important step is to now create the directories in Hadoop which are going to be used as the Hive warehouse. So before that, make sure your Hadoop daemon process are running. So as you can see, my name node, data node are up and running. So as you can see, currently I have the location for Hadoop only. So let's create the Hive warehouse location. So once this is done, also make sure to change the permissions of this location. CFS DFS change mode plus W. Okay, and similarly you can also change this to the slash TMP. So once these changes are done, let's go back and start our Hive. So let's go back to our home directory and execute Hive from there. Okay, so looks like there is some error here, exception thread, illegal character, expansion character. So there is some error in the Hive site.xml. Let's go back and fix that up. Okay, so as you can see here on this particular line of 3210, there's this special character that has come in. So just make sure to delete that. It's only in the description. So now let's go back and hit Hive. Okay, so this is the second common error that we will encounter. Okay, URI syntax exception, URL absolute path error UI. So for this, what we need to do is we need to modify four properties in Hive site.xml. Okay, so the first one is hive.exec.scratch directory. So this would be in slash tmp hive. And add the username. Just like that. Next one is the local scratch directory, hive.exec.local.scratch. crash directory. So for this also we'll just change the value to something like this. User.name slash tmp user.name. Yeah, and the next one is okay. So even for this we'll just change the path with the value section. So just copy the entire. Okay, so looks like I made a mistake here. So the correct one. And coming to the resources directory, just make sure to put this here. Underscore resources. And finally, the directory permissions, which is here. Hive scratch directory permissions. Change it to 733. Okay, so these are the four changes that you need to do. This is done. So let's go back and hit our Hive. Okay, so I made a mistake here for this crash directory. So instead of slash, just replace with hyphen. That should do the trick. Once the changes are done to a configuration files, which is basically hivesite.xml and hiveenv.sh, the next important thing is to initiate the meta schema. So execute the schema tool with the DB type option, Derby database init schema. So if you properly put the Hive bin into the path, you should be able to get this command. So as you can see, our schema tool has completed and the initialization has been done. So as you can see, we have the metastore DB also created. So now let's go back and log into our Hive shell. Okay, and by default you will have only one DB, which is a default DB. So you can also log into Hive using the bline command line, which is available in Hive Server 2 and above versions. It will not work with any of the Hive versions below Hive 2. So again, there are multiple ways to log in with the bline. One is bline-u jdbc Hive 2. Okay, so this is one way. Second way is also you can provide the IP address, which is 10,000. And log in directly. So you can ignore these warnings for now. Okay, so show databases. Let's also create a database. Okay. So as you can see, we have created a DB. Use DB demo. Create table test one. So let's say column one int, column two string. Show tables. So this is our table that we created. So drop table test one, drop database DB demo. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and also don't miss out to subscribe to this channel.